We know that Instagram is a great way to grow your business. We also know that quote cards are something, one of the most popular things that people share on Instagram. So today I'm going to teach you how to create beautiful, share-worthy content for your Instagram account. Be sure to stay to the end of this video for a fantastic free guide that's going to help you grow your business. If you're looking to become more socially savvy, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell so you get notified every week when we post new videos. Hi, I'm Jeannie Wilson. And believe it or not, many moons ago, I went to college for marketing. It was even before social media, if I can date myself just a little bit. And I'm still working in marketing because I love it so much. I so enjoy teaching and helping our clients learn how to use amazing tools that are out there, including Canva and including Instagram. And you can even use this video if you'd like to use it to train your VA on how to create amazing Instagram quotes in Canva. If you're ready to become a rock star on Instagram, let's get started.
Okay, so here we are in Canva. If you don't already have a Canva account, just go to canva.com and you can sign up for a free account. There are some really nice features on the pro account, the paid version, which I'll show you as we go along, but it's not necessary for what I'm going to show you today. So the first thing we're going to do is go up here and click on create a design. And if it didn't already come up, you know, you could just type in, we're going to do an Insta, if I can spell it properly, Instagram post. So those are all the different things that you can do that come up. So we're going to click on Instagram post. And the beauty of this is that it automatically sizes it to the correct size that we want for an Instagram post. So that's really nice. Now up here is where you can name this. Insta quote. And you can see up here on the left says all changes saved. So obviously on the right hand side, this is our canvas that we're going to use to create what we want to create. And then up here on the left hand side, this is great. This is, you're in the templates tab, and this just gives you a ton of different options for different types of posts that you can create. So they've already got these templates in here, and if you put your cursor over them and you see free, that means they're absolutely free. And then you can see this little triangle in the corner. Some of them are actually animated, which I'll show you how to do in just a minute. If you had a particular topic that you wanted to see if they already had some pre-made ones, you could just type that in up here in the search. But otherwise, you know, if you find one, it'd probably be best to find one that was, you know, had a kind of a layout that you liked, because, you know, then you've already got a few elements started. And but we can change all the elements. I'm going to show you how to do that. So we're going to pick a really, really simple one because it's going to be for a quote card. So this is the one that I've selected. And if I click on this because I want to make some changes here, you can see there's a dotted line around the square. And what that means is that there are a bunch of different elements that are grouped together. So I want you to think about this template as a bunch of different elements that are layered. They're all on top of each other. So if I click on this and then I go up here to the three dots and I hit ungroup, now you can see the quote is an element, the white background is an element, the two texts are different elements. So I'm going to click away, and now I can click on each element separately. So this element, I know these colors are not our branded colors, so I want to change that first of all. So I'm going to go up here and click color. And one of the nice things about the upgraded version is that it has this section. You can see here with the little crown, and it automatically pulls up our brand colors because there's a section in here we set that up in. So that is a nice feature for the upgraded version, but, you know, not necessary. So I'm going to change this to a dark purple. Now I'm going to go ahead and change one of the backgrounds. So when I click here, this is this background I can see, because if I just select, you know, left click my mouse and I drag it around, I can move it where I want to. And I can also drag the corners and make it smaller. So but we're gonna not change it too much. But what I do want to change on this one is I want to change the color. So I'm gonna click here and go to one of our lighter colors. And then I'm gonna click the background because the background is actually just slightly tinted. And I'm gonna change that to one of our other colors. So now this is a little bit more, I'm gonna make that a little bit bigger again. It's a little more branded to our business, and I like that. So the next thing I wanna do here is I'm gonna click on the text, and I've created a document that has some nice quotes that I wanna use. So we're gonna do this first one. Inaction breeds doubt and fear. Action breeds confidence and courage. So I'm gonna copy that, and then I'm gonna highlight the text, and I'm gonna paste it in there. Now, I can see here that, first of all, it's not the font that we normally use for our brand. So I'm going to highlight it again, and I'm going to change the font up here. Now, another nice thing that Canva does, the upgraded version of Canva does, is that it puts your branded fonts at the top. Otherwise, you either have to type in the name or you scroll. It's all alphabetical. So that's a really nice feature. Now, I'm also going to change the size because I think it can be bigger than that. Fit and still fit nicely. Now, if I wanted to change the size, you can just grab the sides. And then if you want to move the box, you have to go over and get the crosshairs, and then you can move the whole box. So I'm liking that. And you can click out of it, see what it looks like. I could even make that a little bit bigger, but I'm okay with that. And now I'm going to put the author, who is Dale Carnegie. And paste that there. And then I'm going to change the color of the text because this is brown, which went with the colors that were used on here, but now we've changed the color. So I want to make that fit even better. I'm going to make that a little bit bigger too. So it's more legible. I'll move that up a little bit. Now, if I wanted to change this, which I do, I want to change the font. If I wanted to use this font, which is, as you can see, a little bit scripty, I would call it. It's probably not a word, but it's, you know, it's very design heavy. So first of all, I can see that it's very difficult to read because it's all capitals. So I'm going to retype it. I wonder if it's set up to all capitals. So if I go up here, it was already set to all caps. So I go up here and I click here, which allows me to go from capitals to, you know, small and large letters. I think that's right. It's car, N-E-G-I-E. And so because it's that scripty font, I want to make it bigger so it's more easier to read. And one of the other things that you can do, if it were spaced too close together, you can make it larger. You can spread it out a little bit. And when you're using one of these fancy fonts, that's usually a good idea. C-A-R-N-E-G-I-E. C-A-R-N-E-G-I-E. Okay, got that. So I like how that looks. So the next thing I would do, if I'm happy with this and I'm done, I can click download. And you're going to want to download this as a PNG. That's a really nice small file size, but it gives you all the color that you'd like. One of the nice things with the upgraded version is you also have this option to do a transparent background. So if you were creating an image that was maybe a circle and you didn't want the white background, you just wanted it to show the circle, you could click on that and it wouldn't, the background would be transparent. And that's a really nice feature with the upgraded version. So then all you need to do is click download, save it where you want to save it, and upload it to Instagram and add your hashtags and your copy, and you're good to go. Now, I'm going to show you something else that you can do with this that's really kind of fun. You can click on animate, and you can click on block, or fade, or tumble. you can take a graphic like this and make it really fun and interesting and kind of crazy. So if we wanted to do that, we could go ahead and click download, and it automatically selects that you want to download it as a video. Now, if you didn't want the animation, but you still wanted the image, you can just change that to PNG. But we could go ahead and download that as an MP4 video file and upload that to Instagram, which is really, really fun. And you can use that anytime. You can use that in Instagram stories as well. So let's go ahead and create a new design. And we're going to create an Instagram post. So we'll do one more together just so you can see a few different things. So I'm going to click on this one. Now this one's already animated, which is kind of fun. So you can click there and just see how, you know, the hearts kind of disappear and reappear and the faces move and stuff. So that's really, really fun. So we're going to change this text into one of our quotes. So I'm going to click on this. And you can see that it has the dotted lines around it. So we're going to go up here and hit ungroup. And then the background color on this, I'm going to see if I changed this to our purple. Yeah, that still works. And then I'm going to get rid of this text box just so I can show you how to do your own text box from scratch. But here you can see that this is actually text on top of a box. So you can just delete those individually. So now we just have our text. So I'm going to go over here to quotes again. We're going to do Eleanor Roosevelt. With the new day comes new strength and new thoughts. And then we're going to put it in there. I want to move that down a little bit, because I'm also going to change it to our font, one of our branded fonts. And then I'm gonna change the size. Can even make it bigger. And then drag the side out because I want it to stretch out a little bit more. And if I hit return there. So if you're feeling good and feeling like this is something that you can do, I want you to type in the comments below the word yes, because I'm excited for you that you've learned this. And you can also go up here to effects and you can change, you know, you can add some shadow or some, that's probably a little hard to see. You can make the text hollow or splice it or echo. So, you know, don't be afraid to click on some of these buttons at the top to try some new things out, because you can always hit undo up here and it will undo whatever you've just done. So now we want to add another element, which is going to be text. And we're going to add, we'll just add a regular Sans Source Pro, but we're going to need to make this bigger. And we're going to need to move it down. And we'll go over here and copy Eleanor Roosevelt's name. So I'll have to spell it again. And paste that there. And then I think I'm going to make this a scripty font too. But again, you can see it looks, it's so much smaller when it's that fancy font. And it also is very smushed together. So we're going to click on it and go up here and make the letter spacing bigger. And if you had two different lines and you wanted to give that a little space as well, you could use the line height here. But since this is only on one line, we'll just need that. And then maybe we'll make that just a little bit bigger. So then we can play it. See how that looks. Yep, I think that's cool. Okay, so again, download as an MP4, download, save it to your computer, to your laptop, to your desktop, to your phone, and then go ahead and upload that to Instagram. Again, there's lots of different elements over here on the left-hand side that you can add to any of your designs. you wanted some ice cream in there. You can type in something that you were specifically looking for, a shape. There's some really fun stickers here that you can go through and add them. And especially in Instagram, you know, we add all those fun things. So feel free to play around and get creative and start creating some fantastic Instagram quote cards in Canva.
My business really took off when I started outsourcing, and we have some fantastic people who work for us. I even have a virtual assistant who handles a lot of my social media. Did you know that you can outsource that? And did you know there's tons more things that you can outsource as well? Get the free guide below so you can check out what you can outsource in your business. If you enjoyed this video, be sure to like it, subscribe to our channel, and ring the bell to get notified every week when we post new videos. And feel free to share this with your virtual assistant if you'd like them to learn how to create quote cards in Canva for your Instagram account. Thanks for being here. See you on the next video.